Yesterday, we just got our first expedited request approved. This is a big deal because this process has pretty much been canceled for the past 2 years due to the pandemic. And now they're finally back. Not everywhere, but at least it's here in LA. Let's get to it. Hi everyone, this is Joseph. I'm the managing partner here at Tsang Associates, where we solve legal problems with creative solutions. So this is how the story went down. Our client filed a normal green card application last year around October of 2020, but they still haven't gotten their combo card yet. What is a combo card? It's a travel permit and a work permit together. Now they need that in order to leave the country, and they've been waiting for over 9 months from October till now, it's July. And they need that in order to leave the country. But because they don't have it, and if they leave, they abandoned their entire green card application. In the past, a few years ago, you usually get a combo card within 2 months, maybe three, and even then, that's already really long for people who need to leave the country immediately, right? Well, in this case, they've been waiting for 9 months. So they tried to do an expedited processing by themselves. They called the InfoPass, they went inside to the USCIS Center, and then presented their case. And you know what? The officer didn't even take a look at the application and told them to go home. This was back in March. They really can't wait any longer. So around May or June, they contacted us and said, please, can you see if you can help us? We just attended one of the USCIS meetings and we heard from the district director. And it's not in the minutes, it was just verbally saying that they are resuming this expedited processing request. So we grab hold of this opportunity, told the client we can potentially give it a shot. And we contacted InfoPass within 48 hours. We got an appointment, we prepared the application. So the two urgent reasons is because their mother is hospitalized due to a stroke and that they have been stuck in the US for 20 months. Before they even filed the green card application, they were here as a tourist for close to 6 months. So you add all that time together because of the pandemic, because they are just stuck here, they need to go back to their home country to sell everything and to transfer their livelihood to the US now that they are trying to get permanent residency. And so you can imagine the hardship being stuck in a different country that you weren't planning for. So both of these reasons we presented to the officer, the USCIS officer took it to the supervisor took it to the district director came down and negotiated with us and essentially presented two options. The first option, they would immediately print out an advance parole, but only for one person in the family. There were four people. Presented only to one person. You can go back and take care of your mom. The second option is that they will call USCIS and get the combo card issued, but it will be issued within 10 to 15 days and mailed to their house. So those were the two options presented. The clients, their attorney present there, they called me at the office, we were all discussing, and they decided the second option is probably best. They can wait an additional 10 to 15 days, get the advance parole, then leave the country. And that's is a huge relief because they've been stuck here for 20 months. Finally, they can wrap up things here in the US, go back, take care of everybody there back in their home country, and then come back and get the green card. This is breaking news in the immigration world because normally you might have to wait months and months, if not years, before you get your combo card, before you get your green card, but it's so inconvenient. With this being back, you can potentially jump the line and get it within a few weeks, if not get it the day of, if it's a life and death situation back at your home country. This isn't like a creative solution to a legal problem. Well, it is because it's an exception. But the thing to know about this request is that it's between person to person, right? These applications, they're filed on paper, they get mailed out, there's an officer sitting behind a desk, they're processing hundreds of these cases, there's a super long backlog. You know how it is. If you've worked in an office, you generally know what the work lifestyle is. But sometimes it's extremely important and you need that exception. And that can only be done person to person. And in this digital age where everything is done through text, being able to present your case well, that is the bread and butter of an attorney. So knowing how to do that well, knowing how to do that in person, and being willing to go with the client to the office and make this request, that is the key, and that is the reason why this case was approved. If you have any questions about expedited processing, feel free to contact us. We're super excited because this is fresh off the plate, and this is gonna change so many of our clients' lives, and we just wanna share that with you. And that's a wrap. Take care, bye-bye.